H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Next is, we'll see about listeners, which is used with Selenium WebDriver. What is a listener first? Listeners works very silently without hampering the main Selenium WebDriver script. So it works very independently of the Selenium WebDriver script. So even if the WebDriver might give you that the particular script has passed or failed, listener will give you the actual result. So even if, let's say, the Selenium WebDriver is telling you that the particular test case has passed, listeners might tell you it has failed. So if you want to understand that which result is a genuine result, listener's result will be the genuine result in comparison to Selenium WebDriver script's result. So using listener, we will actually come to know the result of an action before the action actually happens or after the action has happened. So before an action happens, let's say before I click on the sign in button, the listener will know that the sign in will happen or not. After clicking on the sign in button, the sign in has happened or not, listeners will know first. So let's say I go to username and password and click on the sign in button. Now, will the sign in happen successfully or not? Before you click on the sign in, listeners will know that. And after you click on the sign in, listeners will be the first thing to know that sign in has been successful. Now, action out here in the second point means, for example, before clicking on the sign in button, as I have told you, listeners will know sign in will be successful or not. Similarly, after the sign in happens, listener will know the sign in has happened or not. So listener will throw the result before or after the action. The action can be your clicking, the action can be typing in something. So before you type on something, and would you get the result after typing, that listener will know. After you do the action of typing, has the result come or not, listeners will be the first to know that. So listener will throw the result before an act or after the action is performed, irrespective of whatever result is shown by Selenium WebDriver script. So in some scenarios, Selenium script will show pass, listener might show fail. So if you want to believe, you should believe the listener's part rather than the Selenium WebDriver script result. The actual result is from the listener side. That is why I've written out like this. In Selenium WebDriver, if we want to use listeners, we need to use the WebDriver EBIT listener interface. Okay, so if you want to use listeners in Selenium WebDriver, we need to use this particular interface called as WebDriver Event Listener Interface. But please understand one thing, WebDriver Event Listener Interface cannot be used directly with Selenium script. Then how do we use it? So we need to use a particular class which implements the WebDriver Event Listener Interface, and that class which implements the WebDriver Event Listener Interface is called Abstract WebDriver Event Listener Interface. And this Abstract WebDriver Event Listener class which implements the WebDriver Event Listener Interface has a lot of abstract methods. Okay, so how do you do that? So let's check it out. Let's go one by one. Okay, so what you need to understand is that let's go to the seleniumhq.org first, and let's go to the download sections and open up the Java docs. We'll see that there's an interface called as WebDriver Event Listener Interface. Yeah, this is an italic format. So this interface has to be used with Selenium WebDriver script in order to use listeners with Selenium WebDriver. Now this interface cannot be used directly with Selenium WebDriver script. There is a class which implements this interface that class is called Abstract WebDriver Event Listener class. Okay, this class has a lot of abstract methods. If you click on this particular class, it has a lot of abstract methods. For example, there will be a method called as after change value of after click on. So after click on, after you click on a button, you can use this particular method. Before click on, there will be a method. Before click on. Before you click on a button, you can use this particular method. And the method passes the web element and the web driver. You can see that. Similarly, there is a method called as after find by. So after you find an element, you can use this particular method. After find by. And you can have to pass on the by class. You have to pass on the web element interface and the web driver interface as an argument of the after find by. This will be used after you find an element. So there will be a method called as before find by. And these are the arguments of it: the by class, the web element interface, and the web driver interface out here. Similarly, there will be a method called as before navigate back. Before you navigate back, so there's a back sub method of the navigate method that we have just now saw. So we can use this particular method before we navigate back. So there will be also a method called as after navigate back. See, this will be used after we navigate back. So this method can be used before, after you perform the action of navigating back to the particular page, and this particular method can be used before navigate back, before you click on the, so this method will come into force before you click on the back button of your browser, or rather before you use the back sub method of the navigate. Similarly, there will be a method called as after navigate forward. Okay, you pass on the web driver interface out there. This can be used, or this method can be used, after you have used the forward methods or the sub method of the navigate method of web driver interface. Similarly, there will be a method called as before navigate forward. This can be used before you use the forward method of your navigate method of your web driver interface. So these are certain abstract methods, and you can have its own body. You can have all these methods implemented, and you can have its own body. Now, how do we implement it? That is the question. So for implementation, what we need to do is, for example, my class name is MyListeners. So I will have to inherit this abstract WebDriver Emote Listener class, which is a class which implements the WebDriver Emote Listener interface. So there's a way that you can use the WebDriver Emote Listener interface in your Selenium script. This interface actually is used to implement listeners in Selenium WebDriver. But you cannot directly use the WebDriver Emote Listener interface. You have to use a class called abstract WebDriver Emote Listener class, which implements the WebDriver Emote Listener interface. So how do you implement this particular procedure? What you need to do is that you need to create a class called MyListener class, which I've created all out already. And you can see it in the works in Selenium 21 project. There is a package called as listener. Okay. So there is a class called MyListener. Okay. And I'm extending, or rather inheriting, the abstract WebDriver Emote Listener class. This class implements the WebDriver Emote Listener interface. This is the procedure. So we need to look at the procedure steps. So I need to create my own class. I can give any name to my class. Right now the class name is MyListener. It has to extend this particular class called abstract WebDriver Listener. And this class inherently implements the WebDriver Emote Listener interface, which is an interface used for implementing listeners in Selenium WebDriver script. Now, if you look at, I have used four methods: before navigate back, and I passed on the WebDriver driver interface inside it, and this is a simple hard coding. So before navigate back function will be called before we use the navigate back function of Selenium WebDriver. I'm just going to copy this. Similarly, I have used one more method. These methods are, you can see it in the Java docs. These are all abstract methods of your this class. Okay, so I have used the after navigate method. I passed on the WebDriver interface as an argument of it, and all these are non-static methods. You can see that. How do I know? If you go to your Java docs, you will see that, let's say I've implemented the after navigate, but if you click on that, it's all public non-static methods. Before navigate forward is also public void method. After navigate forward is also public void. Okay, before navigate. So I've used these four functions. Before navigate back, so this will, I've just hard coded a particular body part. You can have any body right now. So before navigate better get back function, before navigate back function will be called before we use the navigate back function of Selenium WebDriver. This function is also a non-static function, and after navigate back function will be called after we use the navigate back function. Similarly, before navigate forward can be used, this is a hard coding, will be called before we use the navigate forward function of Selenium WebDriver. This will be also of Selenium WebDriver. Similarly, after navigate forward will be called after we use the navigate function of navigate forward function of Selenium WebDriver. So this is what you need to do first. You have to create a class. You have to inherit this particular abstract WebDriver event listener class, which is a class which implements the WebDriver event listener interface. Once we do that, then there is another class that I have created inside the same package called listeners using navigate function. Now if you look at this using navigate function class, okay, I have basically used the Firefox driver, and if I want to use the Firefox driver, I need to use this particular set of code also to open up the Firefox browser using the Gecko driver concept. Okay, now then we need to first register the listener to the user navigation function class. So this is a class that I've created, and I need to register the listener to this particular class. How do you register? For registering purpose, we use the event firing WebDriver class. Okay, so if you go back to your Java documents and look out at event firing WebDriver class, this is the class, event firing WebDriver class. If you look at the documentation of it, you will say that a wrapper around an arbitrary WebDriver instance which supports registering of the WebDriver event listener interface. So if you want to use listeners in WebDriver, you have to use this interface. Now this interface cannot be used. There's a class which implements this interface called as abstract WebDriver event listener class. And that class is inherited by my listener class. And these are the methods of the abstract WebDriver event listener class, which is used in your my listener class. After that, this is another class that we have created. And I've opened the WebDriver. Rather, I've opened the Firefox browser using the Firefox driver class. After that, we have to register the listener. Which listener? My listener class has to be registered with this particular class. How do you register? By using the event firing WebDriver. Why are you using the event firing WebDriver class? Because if you look at the Java documentation, it will tell you it's a wrapper around the arbitrary WebDriver instance which supports registration of this interface with your Selenium WebDriver script. So that is why I'm using this particular class. Now if you look at the constructor of this particular class called as event firing WebDriver class, you will see the constructor is only this constructor which passes on the WebDriver out here. And that's what I've done. I've used the Firefox driver class to open up the Firefox browser. I am registering my listener class inside using navigation function class by using the event firing WebDriver class. And if you look at the constructor, it passes on the driver. Driver is the reference variable of the WebDriver. And that's what is shown in the Java document also. I need to pass on the WebDriver instance inside the object of event firing WebDriver class. That is how, why I'm registering it with your event firing WebDriver class. So this event firing WebDriver object is referenced by eDriver. Okay. Once I do that, the next thing is that I need to create an instance of the MyListener class. This is the MyListener class. I need to create an instance of it. And then I use the register method of your event firing WebDriver class in order to register the MyListener with this class. So there's a registration process. Okay. So before the registration process, the abstract WebDriver EventListener class has to be extended by MyListener class. This is the class that I've created. And these are the methods of the abstract WebDriver EventListener class. And this class implements the WebDriver EventListener interface. Now these methods will be used before you navigate back, after you navigate back, before you navigate forward, after you navigate forward. Now this is the class that I have again created, Selenium WebDriver script simple. Now I've opened up the web Firefox browser by using this particular method. Now I'm doing a registration. Registration of which class? This class, which has the listener part. With which class? With this particular class. How do I do registration? By using this object. Why I'm using this particular object of event firing WebDriver class? Because this is what is shown. It's a wrapper around the arbitrary WebDriver instance which supports registration of WebDriver event listener. That is why I'm using this particular class, and I'm passing on the WebDriver driver reference variable based on the constructor defined out here. This is the constructor. After that, I create an instance of the MyListener class inside the user navigate function class. So this is what is the instance. And then I use the register method of event firing WebDriver class in order to register MyListener class inside this class. This is why, that's why I passed on M. After that, I use the eDriver, which is the reference variable of event firing WebDriver, to navigate to bbc.com. And then I click on the link, the same thing that I had done in this particular class. The same thing that I'm doing out here, but using the listeners. Okay, I'm clicking on this particular link right now. The same link, that is the mode premier league talks on safe landing. Okay, so I'm finding the element by the XPath for that particular link and clicking on that, but I'm using the event firing WebDriver listeners reference variable. Then use the back method. So before I use the back method, then the back method is nothing but a method, sub method of your navigate. I'm using it with the eDriver reference variable, which is a reference variable of event firing WebDriver. So before I click on the use the back method, I'm using a sysout statement before back. Then the thread.sleep, then I use the back method. There's a thread.sleep, again I use the system.out.println after back. Similarly, again I use the forward method with the, which is a sub method of navigate. And before I use the forward method, I'm using the println command before forward, and after it has forwarded, the println command after forward. So what is going to happen is that there's an action performed out here. The back method is action. So when the before use the back button, a back method rather, what will happen is that this MyListener is now registered with this particular class. So when what happens is that before you use the back method, this method will come into play before navigating back. Similarly, after you have used the back method, this method will come into foreplay now after navigating back. Why? Because you have registered the MyListener class inside this class. Similarly, before you use the forward method, this method of MyListener will come into foreplay, the before navigating forward. After you have used the forward method, this method of MySelenium will come into foreplay. That is called the after navigating forward method. So let's see, let's run this. So what I need to do is that I will close the browser and save the class file and run it. Say OK. So it clicks on the link. Now it uses the back method. Before it goes back, the before navigate back method will come into foreplay. After it navigates back, after navigate back method will come into foreplay. Now it is going forward now using the forward method of navigate. So before it navigates forward, the before navigate forward method will come into foreplay. After it navigates forward, the after navigate forward method will come into foreplay, as defined in the MyListener class. So let's look at the console result. Before back is coming from here. Okay. Now, where are you getting this from? Before navigate back function will be called before we use the navigate back function of Selenium WebDriver. This is coming from the body of this class. Then what's it happening? After and back, where it is coming from? Here. After that, you will see that the after back is coming out here. So after the back method comes into foreplay, the immediate thing that is going to come into force is this particular method. So that is why you see this line out here, and then after you see the after back stuff, which is part of your this particular class. Then before forward will come into foreplay, this println command will come into foreplay. That is why you see this. Before you use the forward method, this method will come into foreplay, and that is why you see the body part of this before navigate forward function will be called, and all those stuff is defined out here. After it has used the forward method, this method will come into foreplay, and that is why you see the body part of this in your console. After that, you see the after forward, which is coming from this particular class. That is how listeners comes into force. So you see, the listeners will come into force before action is performed or after action is performed. The action out here is the back action or the forward action. So before the back action comes into force, the listeners will come into force. That is, this method will come into force. After the back action has happened, immediately this method will come into force. Similarly, before the forward action happens, this method is coming into force. Immediately after the forward action has happened, this method is coming into force. So that is how listeners work, and it does not affect the simple Selenium WebDriver script and anyhow. Okay, that is how we need to use listeners. And that is what is defined in your PPT also. If you look at your PPT, it tells you that for this example, our own class is termed as MyListener, and we'll inherit the abstract WebDriver event listener. This MyListener, which is our own class, has to be registered with the Selenium WebDriver script. In our case, it is using navigation function class. For registration, we need to use the class called EventFiringWebDriver class. Why EventFiringWebDriver class? Because a wrapper around an arbitrary WebDriver instance which supports registration of the WebDriver event listener. We need to create a constructor EventFiringWebDriver class in the Selenium script. That is what we have done. Use navigate function. Then create an object of the class called MyListener in using navigation function. Register MyListener in the register with the register method of EventFiringWebDriver. And that's what we have done out here. So here we are using this particular class to register MyListener class inside with this particular class. Okay, but I'm using this particular constructor which passes on the WebDriver instance. Then I'm using the instance of MyListener class, which is nothing but this class. And then I'm registering with the register method of event firing, where I'm registering which particular class, my listener class, with this class. And that is why I'm passing on M. And then move forward with it. So that's about listeners. Let's move forward now.